What's the job?
The weak must be protected.
The hunt begins.
Come on, let's do this.
Do not waste my time.
We must light the
way. Let's have some fun.
We lived in an age of wonders. We wove magic into steel and shaped the elements with our words. And yet, even in this golden age, there were stories of cities falling to darkness, of a force reaching from the shadows. We didn't believe them until it came for us. The beacons had always been a part of our world. We never knew who created them, or that someday they would return. Defenseless.
We must get to the beacon!
This is foul magic. Silo, clear a path.
On it!
Horns, anger issues. Remind you of anyone?
Shut up and fight.
There are too many. Make for the gate!
Through.
What now?
Now, Wingrave, we light the beacon. Somehow, these markings. I can do this. But I'll need some time.
Precursor! We have to buy her some time!
False one! This is vengeance for my people.
I am sorry.
No!
Just a little longer.
Damn.
We are so close.
You've done it. The light. Your gods are dead. Your world is ours.
Remember, I'm called Silo. My family were smugglers, outlaws. But they live by a code. Did what was best for the people. Now, it's up to me to fight the gloom and to find out what's happened to my family.
Praise the architects. I thought we'd lost you. We need to get you back to Skylight. There's no time to explain. You're trapped within the gloom. But with that shard, you can cut through the shadows. You must move quickly. I will guide you as best I can. It is so good to see you again. I thought we'd lost you forever. Don't worry. Your memories will return, in time. That battle took place a year ago, and you were lost in the gloom. We've been trying to bring you back ever since. Let me show you. The Eldrin attack was a distraction. The beacon was always the target. We pushed past them and found the creature who was leading the attack. And you did what needed to be done. You fought to the bitter end. And your sacrifice bought me the time we needed. There's so much we don't yet know about the beacon. But its power protects this city. It destroyed our enemies and stopped the Gloom Tear from expanding. We couldn't close the Gloom Gate. But as long as the beacon remains lit, our enemies can't pass through it. And in the year that followed, we've studied it, learned more about this gloom, learned how to bring you back. We survived thanks to you. But the damage is done. Skylight is safe and the land around it. But beyond the Highlands, reality is collapsing into the gloom. There may be other beacons, other places that repel the invaders. The only way to find out is to cut a path through the gloom. And for that, we need Wayfinders. We need you. Your sacrifice, and that of the others, bought me the time I needed to light the beacon. And the beacon's light holds the gloom at bay. It's the only reason we're alive. We still don't know. A year ago, the Eldrin attacked us and extinguished the beacon. And it was then that the gloom began to spread. It corrupts and consumes reality. The beacon protects us. But beyond its light, the gloom has swallowed the world, leaving only shadows and chaos. We don't know if anyone else has survived. That's why we need you. You survived in the gloom. You can do it again. With the tools you've been given, you can cut through its shadows. You must be a Wayfinder. We still know so little about the gloom. And so much of the world has been lost to it. We need you to enter the Lost Zones, to find a path through the shadows. You've been through an ordeal. I shouldn't burden you with this now. It's best you see what's left of Skylight, and meet other Seekers. You were a Seeker once. You've just forgotten. Before the Gloomfall, we investigated ancient mysteries. Now it's the Seekers who are working to keep Skylight and its people alive. Go to the Great Hall, up above the plaza. Wolf will want to meet you. We'll talk again after you've met with him and Lord Halar.
Wayfinder. You honor us with your presence. I fought the Eldrin during the attack, just as you did. But it was your sacrifice that saved Skylight. Worf. Before the fall, I was an officer of the Eivor Imperium. Now I command our forces, such as they are. There are all too many threats. Shrikes, breaches. But you'll see for yourself soon enough. We will have much to discuss in the days ahead. Then we'll have quarters for you soon enough. Much of Skylight was devastated in the attack. The builders are working as quickly as they can. You have more important work ahead of you. But for now, find Lord Halar outside of the Great Hall. He'll get you ready for the tasks that lie ahead.
The new Wayfinder. Delightful. I am Lord Halar. As you know, my lands and the Dominion itself have been swallowed by the gloom. But even now, especially now, names matter. I lead the Arcanists among the Seekers. By necessity, we have focused our efforts on restoring Skylight. But it is my studies of the gloom that can help you, not my knowledge of arcanic illumination. What we know for certain is that the gloom alters flora and fauna, and never for the better. Where it lingers, it can consume entire regions, leaving only shadows in the gloom. What we call lost zones. You were consumed by the gloom, but you survived. Now you have the power to shape it, to some degree. The shard you've been given focuses this gift. Only a Wayfinder can enter a lost zone. But this is just a glimmer of your full potential. If you can enforce your will upon the gloom, perhaps one day we can undo the damage that has been done. But I can only tell you of the gloom. Omen can show you. Return to her, near the Gloom Gate, Wayfinder. She will guide you in the next steps of your journey.
Spoken with Worf and Lord Halar. I am sure you have many questions, but the best way for you to understand the gloom is to experience it for yourself. The gloom is consuming our world. Our beacon holds it at bay, but much was lost before it was lit. Beyond Skylight, you will find breaches where the gloom has ripped away pieces of our world. Using the focusing shard, you can pass through breaches to reach a shadow of what was lost, what we call lost zones. These are unstable and unpredictable, reflecting what was or what might have been. We're running out of time. The gloom is breaking down our defenses and we don't know how to stop it. We need you to explore the lost zones, to find a way to fight the gloom and reclaim our world. We do know the large gate behind me is the key. In theory, you can reach any lost zone through this gate. In practice, there are limitations. Usually, you must find and enter a breach directly to access a lost zone for the first time. After that, you can access it in any other breach you found through this gate. But you can't just stumble into a breach. You need a connection to the lost zone to guide you through it. This might mean finding an object from the zone, or experiencing an event tied to it. For now, I have a single connection I can share with you. The Codex Halls of Aurelion. There. Go to the gate. Follow the connection I have given you and return to the gloom. The shard you've been using is an incomplete tool. Find a Codex Ember in the gloom Then we can transform your focusing shard into a full gloom dagger, allowing you to harness your full potential. This is a lost zone. It's not a perfect replica of the world that was. It's a dream inspired by what was lost. When you return here again, everything, the layout, the creatures within it, may change. This lost zone is tied to Aurelian, a fortress monastery of the Avar Order of the Silver Codex. The Codex monks were conducting arcane research, and we need to know more about them. Aurelian was raised by raiders from the maze years before the Gloomfall. You'll need to establish your own connection to it. Yes. It was a miracle that we could pull you back to Skylight. But like your memories, some of your skills were lost. Don't worry. It will all come back to you in time. This connection I've provided is temporary and unpredictable. Look for a Codex Ember. With it, you can turn your shard into a full gloom dagger and establish your own connections. I can't guide you when you go deeper. To escape, you'll need to find the heart of this lost zone, the anchor, and destroy it. This weakens the gloom and lets us harvest its energy through your shard. Explore as thoroughly as you can. We need the supplies and knowledge you may find. And exploration may grant you connection to other lost zones. Now go, and good luck. What is this? Something new. Something interesting. I hear an echo in the darkness. You have promise, yes. But you don't have what I need. Not yet. Go ahead. Run along home. I'll be watching you, Wayfinder.
I was sure you'd find your way. And with an ember. Good, good. Let's get to work. The Silver Codex studied ways to manipulate arcane energies. We can use the ember you recovered from Aurelion to create your Gloom Dagger and to establish your own connection to the ruins. You see, the shard you claimed in the Gloom is a rough and imperfect tool. You need to make it a true extension of yourself, a blade that can cut through reality. Use the Echo Matrix to combine the Ember and the Shard. Visualize the shape of your dagger. You can draw on the threads of the Gloom and make your vision real. Try it. Perfectly done. Woven from the pure elements of magic and drawn into reality. Now you have what you need to explore lost zones on your own. Let's review that procedure. To reach a lost zone, you need three things. A breach that serves as an entrance, a gloom dagger that can cut a path through the shadows, and a connection to the place consumed by the gloom. A connection can take the form of an object, such as the ember now bound to your dagger, or something more abstract, such as a memory or experience. You now have a gloom dagger, and through the ember you have a connection to the Codex Halls. So, what is it you are missing, Wayfinder? Have you been listening? Yes, just so. You need to find the point at which this area collapsed. You must search the Highlands for a sheet of gloom energy, a hole in the world. Once you've found it, use your dagger to carve a path. Explore what lies beyond, and destroy the anchor of that shadow. Thereafter, you will be able to reach Aurelion through the gloom gate here.
There you are. Your gloom dagger is connected to the beacon of Skylight. Aside from being an invaluable tool for exploring the gloom, it also allows us to communicate through the link. A voice in the gloom? No, that wasn't me. I warned you that the connection would be unstable. Remain alert. but I'm sure it was just some manifestation of the chaos. Lord Halar and I spent much of this last year refining the daggers as we sought to retrieve you from the gloom. As for the shards, that's a tale for another time. But now, I need you to return to the Codex Halls. We need to know more about the work of the Silver Codex. I always thought they were peaceful, devoted sages. Now, I'm not so sure. Our work suggests they were experimenting with a sinister force that may have been the gloom, decades before the Gloomfall. This work could help us push back the gloom, or reconnect our world. As Lord Halar has told you, you must first find the breach tied to the Codex Halls out in the wider world. And that means leaving the safety of Skylight. Before you leave Skylight, I need you to bind your daggers to the signal fires here. This will strengthen your connection to the beacon and help you move quickly across the region. Once that's done, take the lift down to the Highlands and find Warden Haas. She's in charge of our defenses. I will offer guidance when I can. Well met, Wayfinder. Welcome back to the world. What's left of it? It's an ugly business. We're fighting the Shrikes for resources. And out beyond, you've got feral beasts and gloom-spawned monsters. You'll find out soon enough, I fear. Brigands and looters. Some of them half feral from drinking God's blood and other madness. Dangerous is what they are. But what's your business here? Looking for the breach. I'm no wayfinder, but I know it. Head out past the foundry and through the ruined gate walls. Once you get to the swamp, look for the large gnarled tree and weathered steps. Be sure to bind your dagger to the signal fire here. You'll find them across the highlands. Never miss an opportunity to forge a connection. Again, I'm no wayfinder. I've heard they're connected to the beacon, and each connection strengthens its light. As a wayfinder, you can instantly move between the fires. You'll find it a useful tool. On your way then. But we could use another blade out here. These gloom-touch beasts get more dangerous every day. And the Shrikes are even worse. Skylight needs supplies, and it's getting harder and harder to find them. I know you've got your mission, but if you can kill a worm or scare off some Shrikes, we need the help.
As a wayfinder, you alone can try the path through the gloom. But you possess powers and skills beyond those of the Watchers and Rangers. And we must all stand together if any of us are to survive. Many will ask for your help, and I hope you will assist those in need. But it's up to you to prioritize those requests and to use your time wisely. Right now, I need you to return to the Codex Halls and get to the bottom of a mystery. We'll discuss it further once you're inside the ruins.
Yeah.
A previous expedition discovered unnatural deadly spiders in the shadows of Aurelian. Lord Halar believes these aren't spontaneous creations of the gloom. They're tied to the Silver Codex's work. Did the Codex somehow harness the gloom decades before the fall and use it to cause mutations? We need answers. Search for spiders and see what you can find. You aren't the only Wayfinder. You'll meet the others eventually. Now go. There's work to be done.
Thank you.
One moment, Wayfinder. I need to balance the arcanic pressure in this file. There. Now, what have you brought for me? Yes. Yes. These creatures were altered with arcanic power. Shadow, certainly, perhaps a hint of chaos. But this isn't the random work of the gloom. This shows intention. The Codex were monks of the Imperium. They couldn't have done this. Even if they knew how, working with the element of shadow is anathema in the Avar faith. I must know more. Wayfinder, you must find the source of this. But to do so, we must accelerate your training. You must learn to shape the gloom. The gloom is a maelstrom of shadows and chaos. Anchors pull together visions of what might have been, fragments of the whole. And when you leap in blindly, an anchor pulls you in. But you can do more than this. With your dagger, you can cut through the chaos and carve a direct path. You can hunt down an enemy, strike a specific foe. These webs hold traces of a greater threat. I can isolate its spore. I can give you what you need to hunt, but you are not fully prepared. You must meet the other seekers. Each has something you need, tools you can use. Arsenal can arm you. The engineer can give you strength. Venge finds treasures in the rubble. And Omen is the wisest of all. Go, speak to them.
I see a Wayfinder, newborn from the void. You are Skylight's Fist, child, and I am the Weapon Master. I am Arsenal, and I can place steel in your hands. You need a weapon worthy of a legend. Eclipse, the Titan's Bane. I know many weapons you might wield, but all have been swallowed by the gloom. Last, but not forever. We drew you forth from the gloom when you were lost. You can do the same now. You can call an echo of a legendary weapon from the void, and you can make it real. It is no simple thing to find a weapon in the gloom and master it, but I know them all. I can tell you what you need to gather, and together, we will see you armed with a weapon worthy of you.
Delightful, delightful! I'm Venge, and you need what I have, for I have what you need! Whatever that may be. A potion? A poem? What is it now? Good, good! It's hard to get supplies in what's left of the world, but my friends and I comb the broken pieces and find those things you need! I'll be here when you know what that is.
Yes, you may find my appearance unsettling, but trust me, no one knows more about the interaction of magic and metal than I. There is power within you. Accessories will help you focus that power. Their gifts may seem slight, but even the slightest breeze can turn the tide. The greatest accessories cannot simply be crafted. But you, Wayfinder, you can reach within the gloom and pull forth the echo of such a relic. You can dream of a lost legend and make it real. All power has a price. There are things you must find before I can help you. But in the days ahead, you and I will make wondrous things.
To the gloom. We both lost friends on the day of the fall. But they may not be lost forever. It's not easy to pull a wayfinder from the gloom. We need to find the echoes of the hero and use the beacon to create a path they can follow. But together, we can bring them back. There are things I need you to find. Elements of power. Traces of our fallen champions. We need to remember who they were so we can find them in the darkness. We need more wayfinders if we are to survive. Continue your work with Lord Halar, my friend, but be ever watchful for the traces that we need.
Been successful. I've drawn the essence from the webs and found the traces of their maker, the brood mother who spawned these foul things. But before you reach her, you must craft a gloom trace and use it on the gloom gate. I will provide the materials you need this once, but in the future, you will need to find them yourself. Once made, the gloom trace will guide you directly to your prey. I hope you took advantage of what our seekers have to offer. I fear you will need all the help you can get. I believe we may be able to use these gloom traces to target specific foes in the future, if needed. Craft the gloom trace and then go to the gate. The gloom trace will guide you to your foe. We need to know what the Codex was doing. This broodmother may hold the answer. Good luck. Yes. If this is what I think it is, well, it could change everything. The facets, the fragments, glimmers of gloom and chaotic currents. Give me a moment to study it. The stone that you found in this broodmother, it's a sort of elemental lens, a tool designed to shape the gloom itself. The gloom is a myriad of possibilities, and this stone... How can I explain it? The gloom is fundamentally unstable, Wayfinder. It's said that the celestial architects shaped our world from primordial chaos. I believe that the gloom may be that primal maelstrom. The stone lets you shift between myriad potential realities. But how to use it? It's going to take a surge of elemental power, yes. Perhaps. Your dagger, certainly. I've treated the Myriad Stone. Take it to the Echo Matrix and fuse it to your dagger. Let's see what comes of it.
This is a fascinating tool. I can smooth out the connection. Lord Halar is a brilliant arcanist, but he doesn't understand what you truly are. I should have told you sooner, but I didn't know how to say it. You see, my friend, you didn't survive our battle against the Eldrin. You gave your life to save Skylight. You perished and were consumed by the gloom. For anyone else, that would have been the end. But you refused to let go. You lingered as an echo, holding on until I found you and sent the shard. I gave you the tool you needed, but you imposed your will upon the gloom. You rebuilt your body, and you can do it again if you fall in battle. And I believe that's only the beginning. The dagger focuses your power. Now bound to the stone, I believe you will be able to shape the gloom in ways we've never seen. I'm sure it will take time, but this could be the key to our salvation. Our architects have fallen. Our world is collapsing into the gloom. But if we can master this power, Wayfinder, we may be able to build it anew. This may seem like madness, but consider, you're missing memories, the skills you've had to relearn. You're an echo of my fallen friend, but I believe you've kept the best of them. You can shape the gloom. It's how you craft your weapons, how you return from defeat, how you bind the echoes of your enemies to gain strength. Now you can shape the gloom itself. You'll need to imbue your dagger with concentrated elemental energy. When you cut a path into the gloom, that energy should reshape the Lost Zone, creating a unique layer of reality. I have a charge of elemental shadows. Imbue your dagger with this power and enter the Codex Halls. Let us see what you can do.
Thank you.
impugnment worked. Shadow is the strongest element within the gloom, but I've never seen it as strong as in this zone. It proves the gloom can be manipulated. Making shadows deeper may not help us, but it's a beginning. Experiment with other impugnments. We need to see what's possible. Beyond that, it shows that the Silver Codex was manipulating the gloom in Aurelion decades before the fall. Their work may hold the answers we need. I've seen these before. The monks used them to store information. This is the journal of a Codex initiate named Azarin. He writes about efforts to achieve immortality, to reshape the world. It seems this work was done deeper in Aurelion, in what Azarin calls the Undercroft. But only those who passed the Trial of Lingering Light could enter the Undercroft. And he never did. We've never found a path beyond the Codex Halls. But if you could complete this trial, it might give you a connection to the Undercroft. We have to know what they were doing there. It surely exists somewhere in the echoes of the Codex Halls. There must be some record of it somewhere. I wish there was another option, but I'm afraid I know what you must do. Since the Gloomfall, we've had to put our pasts behind us. Wolf and the Huntmaster were once bitter enemies, but in the face of the gloom, we have to work together. So it is with Kestrel and I. She's a smuggler who used to work with the Shrikes, and she's good at finding things we need. I'll never trust her, but she may be able to help us with this. Kestrel keeps a low profile, but I'm sure you can find her. Ask around the Bitter End. Oh, and Wayfinder. Be careful. Kestrel is not one to divulge information for free.